O Lord, open my lips, and my mouth will declare your praise. Make haste, O God, to deliver me. To the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now and will be forever. Amen. Praise to you, O Christ, King who comes to majestic is your name in all the earth. You have set your glory above the heavens. Out of the mouth of babes and infants, your strength because of your foes, to still the enemy and the other. When I look at your heavens, the work of your fingers, the moon and the stars which you have set in place, what is man that you are mindful of him, and the Son of Man that you care for him? Yet you have made him a little lower than the heavenly beings, and have crowned him with glory and honor. All sheep and oxen, and also the beasts of the field. O Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name in all.
The first reading is from Zephaniah chapter 3. Sing aloud, O daughter of Zion. Shout, O Israel. Rejoice and exult with all your heart, O daughter of Jerusalem. The Lord has taken away the judgments against you. He has cleared away your enemies. The King of Israel, the Lord, is in your midst. You shall never again fear evil. On that day it shall be said to Jerusalem, Fear not, O Zion. Let not your hands grow weak. The Lord your God is in your midst, a mighty one who will save. He will rejoice over you with gladness. He will quiet you by his love. He will exult over you with loud singing. I will gather those of you who mourn for the festival, so that you will no longer suffer reproach. Behold, at that time, I will deal with all your oppressors, and I will save the lame and gather the outcast, and I will change their shame into praise and renown in all the earth. At that time I will bring you in, at the time when I gather you together. For I will make you renowned and praised among all the peoples of the earth, when I restore your fortunes before your eyes, says the Lord. O Lord, have mercy on us.
Thanks be to God.
The second reading is Isaiah chapter 35. The wilderness and the dry land shall be glad. The desert shall rejoice and blossom like the crocus. It shall blossom abundantly and rejoice with joy and singing. The glory of Lebanon shall be given to it, the majesty of Carmel and Sharon. They shall see the glory of the Lord, the majesty of our God. Strengthen the weak hands and make firm the feeble knees. Say to those who have an anxious heart, Be strong, fear not. Behold, your God will come with vengeance, with the recompense of God. He will come and save you. Then the eyes of the blind shall be opened, and the ears of the deaf unstopped. Then shall the lame man leap like a deer, and the tongue of the mute sing for joy. For waters break forth in the wilderness, and streams in the desert. The burning sand shall become a pool, and the thirsty ground springs of water. In the haunt of jackals, where they lay down, the grass shall become reeds and rushes. And a highway shall be there, and it shall be called the Way of Holiness. The unclean shall not pass over it. It shall belong to those who walk on the way. Even if they are fools, they shall not go astray. No lion shall be there, nor shall any ravenous beast come up to it. They shall not be found there, but the redeemed shall walk there. And the ransomed of the Lord shall return and come to Zion with singing. Everlasting joy shall be upon their heads. They shall obtain gladness and joy, and sorrow and sighing shall flee away. O Lord, have mercy on us.
Thanks be to God. Behold, the days are coming, says the Lord, when I will raise up for David a righteous branch.
Saw God perfectly, and they walked with him. It was a very simple relationship. He loved them, and they loved him back. In Eden, they used their ears well. They heard his voice, and they used their lips well when they sang for joy. In Eden, they could leap like deer and play with jackals, no anxiety and no fear. Because life in the garden was one of blossoms and streams, and maybe most of all, life in Eden meant the joy of being at home. Not just the way we wish that we would all be at home this Christmas. The joy of being at home with your Heavenly Father. The joy of walking in the cool of the day with his Son and in the light of his Holy Spirit. Outside of that being and outside of that living, there is dying. Outside of that walking and that light, there is wandering and darkness. Outside of that garden is wilderness. And the wilderness is not a truly happy place, even when things are going moderately well. Fast forward to the captives of whom Zephaniah and Isaiah speak. Even when they are not being captured and led into exile, even when they are not being made into slaves and killed in countless battles, even when things are going well for God's people, outside of Eden is not the joy it was meant to be. Because even when things are going well, some people are still born blind or deaf. And some people's legs don't work right, and some people's mouths can't form words. And so a mother might never even hear that her child loves her. A father may never see his son grow up to be a man. Even when things are going well. Even then, the wilderness is still a place of anxiety and sorrow, of weakness and fear. For God's people, then the wilderness is a place of longing. Longing to live and to not die. Longing to flourish as children and not as exiles and slaves. Longing to be home again with their father. Walking with his son in the light of his spirit. Even when, on the whole, things are going well, our world is not what it is supposed to be. Every day, still, kids are born blind and deaf and mute and lame, and disease and war take our friends and our loved ones from us. Anxiety and fear cripple people, families and relationships. And as it was for God's exiled people, our status as his children does not seem to prevent most of it. We are his children, to be sure. This he has staked not on our own confidence or assertion or even our own sense of faith, but in the blood of his son. And so it is sure and certain because he has done it. And yet we do still get in the way. We do still doubt, and in this fallen world, in this wilderness of our making, this dark, fearful, and vast place, what exiles like you and me need, just like what Israel really needed, is to live in a place of God's making. What we need is to be led home again. But the distance between here and there is so great. And the terrain is so hazardous, and the land is so full of predators, that folks like you and me, with weak hands and feeble knees and anxious hearts, we will never make it. Isaiah's prophecy, then, is not just for Judah. And it does not speak only of their deliverance in time from foreign nations. But the prophecy is for you. Because through his prophets, the Heavenly Father says that he wants the same thing that you want. That what he would really like is to have every one of his children home for Christmas. But because we cannot make it home, he will bring home to us. This is the answer to the questions, like how will our weak hands become strong? And how will our knees get firm and anxious hearts be cured of fear? Only for one reason, and it is because God has promised to come and save you. And history shows he is indeed good on his word. He kept his word to the exiles in Babylon, just the way, same way he kept his word to Moses and his people Israel, just the way he kept his word to Abraham and David. In all these many and various ways, he has kept their promise to them, and he has shown for certain that he will keep it to you. And it is this very passage that speaks to us in our wilderness, in our lostness. It is this very passage that Jesus brings to the attention of John the Baptist, which, by the way, is our clue that it was not merely fulfilled when Judah's captives were delivered. Because he gives it as comfort to John, it means that the prophecy is fulfilled when Jesus comes for you. So he says then, be strong and fear not. Not because you are smart or strong, but because you are weak. Be strong, fear not, for it is the vengeance and the recompense of God that has been poured out already on his son, and not on you. Be strong, fear not. This Christmas, by full manger and full cross, with full heart and empty tomb, Christ has come to save you. He has come to carry you home again to Eden, to his new creation, our sorrowful wilderness now made glad, our deserts full of flowers, our eyes working the way they were always meant to, opened wide to see God face to face, our ears opened the way they were always meant to be opened, to hear his living voice, and our mouths taking the shape they were always meant to, singing praises to God, and our legs strong to dance. You can have that right now. For the church is a place of God's making and not our own. A bright oasis in a dark wilderness, a stream in a desert, and a home for God's pilgrim people, and a place for life amidst death. Because it is you. You are the ransomed of the Lord, and you shall return and come home to Zion with singing. Everlasting joy shall be upon your heads, and you shall obtain gladness and joy, and sorrow and sighing shall flee away. To Christ be all the glory, now and forever, and to the ages of ages. Amen.
Let my prayer rise before you as incense.
Oh.
helped his servant Israel in remembrance of his mercy, as he spoke to our fathers, to Abraham, to his seed forever. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Let us pray. Lord Jesus Christ, we implore you to hear our prayers and to lighten the darkness of our hearts by your gracious visitation. For you live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
O God, from whom come all holy desires, all good counsels, and all just works, give to us, your servants, that peace which the world cannot give, that our hearts may be set to obey your commandments, and also that we, being defended from the fear of our enemies, may live in peace and quietness. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Thank you. rushing home to beat the storm and get bread and milk and all that stuff. Say thanks to our guest organist, Cheryl Ryder, who graciously stepped in for Cantor Wessler, who kind of unexpectedly had to be out of town. So give her a hello and a thanks if you can. God bless you. We'll see you this week.